This is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician and founder of edexitvideo.com. This video is about bowel obstructions. A bowel obstruction happens with either your small or large intestine, partially or completely blocked. The blockage prevents food, fluids, and gas from moving through the intestine in a normal way. Symptoms include abdominal distension, abdominal fullness or gas, abdominal pain and cramping, breath, odor, constipation, diarrhea, and vomiting. The causes can be mechanical, which simply means something's on the way, like abnormal tissue growth, adhesions or scar tissue, foreign bodies, gallstones, hernias, impacted feces, intussusception, tumors, volvulus. And the other cause is ileus, which is a condition that which the bowel does not work correctly, but there is no structural problem. A paralytic ileus, also called a pseudo-obstruction, is one of the major causes of intestinal obstruction in infants and children. Causes of paralytic ileus include chemical, electrolyte, or mineral imbalances, such as decreased potassium levels, complications of intra-abdominal surgery, decreased blood supplies to the abdominal area, like with mesenteric artery ischemia, injury to the abdominal blood supply, intra-abdominal infection, kidney or lung disease, use of certain medications, especially narcotics. In older children, paralytic ileus may be due to bacterial, viral, or even food poisoning, which is sometimes associated with secondary peritonitis or appendicitis. Tests. While listening to the abdomen with a stethoscope, your healthcare provider may hear high-pitched bowel sounds at the onset of the mechanical obstruction. If the obstruction has persisted for too long, the bowel has been significantly damaged, bowel sounds may decrease, eventually becoming silent. Early paralytic ileus is marked by decreased or absent bowel sounds. Tests that show obstruction include abdominal CT scan, abdominal x-rays, barium enemas, and an upper and small bowel series. Treatment involves placing a tube through the nose into the stomach or intestine to help relieve the abdominal distension and vomiting by sucking the air and gastrointestinal contents. Surgery may be needed to relieve the obstruction if the tube does not relieve the symptoms or if there are signs of tissue death. Complications include electrolyte imbalances, infection, jaundice, perforation of the intestine, necrosis, and death of the bowel tissue. If the obstruction blocks the blood supply to the intestine, the tissue may die, causing infection and gangrene. Risk factors for tissue death include intestinal cancer, Crohn's disease, hernia, and previous abdominal surgery. In the newborn, paralytic ileus that is associated with destruction of the bowel wall is called necrotizing enterocolitis, a life-threatening condition, and may lead to blood and lung infections. If you suspect a bowel obstruction, you should be seen immediately in the emergency department. If you had an ileus and discharged from the emergency department and the symptoms are worsening, like abdominal distension, vomiting, fecal smell to the breath or vomitus, low blood pressure or others, you should come back immediately for reevaluation. If you had a small bowel obstruction, then you were most definitely admitted to the hospital. Follow-up will be arranged once you're ready for discharge from the hospital. Once you've had a small bowel obstruction in the past, you will be at high risk of recurrence, so you should make sure your medications and diet are optimized to prevent constipation, since this can lead to another episode of small bowel obstruction. For more videos like this video, please go to edexitvideo.com. And remember, these are educational videos and should never take the place of medical attention. Again, my name is Dr. Carlo Oller, emergency physician. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel.